Fatima, and today I'm going to talk about cabin crew Emirates Airline. So today I will cover the topics interview question and answers, what all the requirements to join Emirates cabin crew airline, and what all the benefits you get once you join the Emirates airline as a cabin crew. Talking about the Emirates airline, so Emirates Airline is one of the most largest airline in the world, and it operates around 2,500 flights per week. And Emirates is the most luxurious airline in the world. The mission is offering consistently high quality value for money service and to be the best airline on all of its roles. And talking about the mission, vision of the Emirates Airline, so to make the civil aviation safe and leading and sustainable, their vision is. Let's come to the point of cabin crew requirements. So there are the technical requirements for the cabin crew airline for Emirates Airline, and this requirement vary from airline to airline. So for Emirates Airline, it is the candidate should be at least 21 year old at the time of joining. He should have a minimum 160 centimeter height with a arm reach of around 212 centimeter. He or she should completed her schooling, and he should be very fluent in English, speaking and writing both. There should not be any visible tattoo on their body, which can be seen when they wear a cabin crew uniform, and they are always ready to adapt new people, new places, and the new situations. So for the Emirates cabin crew, the airline manager will see for the few qualities which every cabin crew should have, that is maturity, adaptability, judgment, tact, diplomacy, grooming, attitude, feeling, friendly, how much friendly they are with the passengers, how much dedicated they are toward their work, and they should be a good listener, because they have to communicate with so many passengers at the same time. They should have a team spirit, and they should be always always ready to take quick decision, and they should have a knowledge, and the most important thing, they should have a patience. Talking about the cabin crew responsibility, so these are the few responsibilities which is the main responsibility for the any cabin crew: safety, first aid, and the services. So cabin crew is responsible for the safety and the comfort zone of the passenger on an airplane, and they are trained to deal with the security and emergency situation that may arise in on board. So they should be always ready. It can be a medical situation, it can be any difficult situation, unruly passenger, anything. And of service, the crew will meet and greet the passenger, and they should provide a safety briefing, food service, and drink. There are the six areas for the cabin management: cabin design and operation, equipment, procedure, cabin crew training, human performance, and the passenger management. These are the six main things which any cabin crew should know, and they are trained once they join the airline. Talking about the recruitment process, so when come to the recruitment process, so there are the five stages: CA review and evaluation, group assessment, height and reach assessment, online English assessment, and a final interview. So I will talk about all these in brief in the coming slide. Assessment dress code. So what dress code is required for the assessment when they go for an interview for cabin crew. So for male candidate, he should have a neat and trimmed hair with a clean shaved face, and he should wear a formal business dress code and a formal formal work shoes. For a female candidate, the candidate should have a neatly tied hair with a classic bunch or a French twist. She should wear a full makeup, and the dress code should be a business attire, and she can wear a high heels and a flat shoes also. Talking about the training journey. So for training journey, once you join the airline, you have to go through the 7 stages. First is induction. The duration for the induction is 8 days. In this, the airline will provide the whole information and assist the candidate during their transition into their new environment within the Dubai throughout the training. And the second stage is the safety and emergency procedure. So safety and emergency procedure, in this, a candidate will train to operate the aircraft equipment, firefighting and in-flight emergency situation and evacuation. So they will, the airline will provide or train the candidate with the skill and the knowledge to ensure the aircraft and the passengers or passengers remain safe at all the times. Talking about the third stage, which is group medical training. So in this training, the candidate will train for the medical incident on board. It can be a childbirth, burns, bleeding, or any medical condition which comes. They are trained so they can take care of any patient or any patient passenger. The fourth stage is the security. This is the most important training for any cabin crew. The training goes for 2 days. In these 2 days, airline will provide with the guidelines, skill and technique to prevent the manage act of unlawful interference, any unruly behavior of any passenger, hijacking and sabotage. They will train all the things which comes under the security for a passenger security. The uniform standard, in this they will train a candidate for skin care, makeup, hair cell, nail care, and a healthy lifestyle. Service personality, in this they will train the candidate how they have to be in front of the passenger and how they have to interact, all the things they will train. And the seventh stage is the service. Duration of this stage is 14 days. So the 14 days training goes for all the trainings. They will go to equipments all, and all the uniform standards, security, all these things. In these 4 days, they will go through all these things. Now coming to the recruitment process again. So the first thing is to become a cabin crew for Emirates Airline, you have to fill the application form. In this, they will ask one question. For that, you have to write an answer for 500 words, and the answer should be in such a way that the Emirates Airline group or a manager or the one who is writing your answer will get impressed by you, and you will get invitation later. So the second thing is the Emirates open days. So in these open days, they will be given opportunity to you. So what they will do is they will provide you lot of information about the Emirates Airline, their brand, what they do and how they do it. So you have to go through all these things, and you have to when you go back to the manager and when you have an interview, you have to present these things in such a way that they should get impressed by your answer. The third is now comes to the cabin crew assessment day. So for this, the first stage is presentation. So in this, the airline will present what they do, all the things of how is the life in Dubai after joining the cabin crew for Emirates Airline, how you are going to live, all the things they will present. The second stage is the group discussion. In this, they will give you a topic, and you have the topic is the same. They will provide you all the information related to the Emirates Airline, what they do, how they do it. In on this thing, you have to go through all the details, and in you have to go for the group discussion. In group discussion, you have to come up with your points. You have to give your you have to present yourself so the airline manager will get impressed by you. The third is the reach test. It is the your height test. You have to reach 212 centimeter height when you stand on your tiptoes. And second is short informal interview. This is the 5-minute interview. In this, the airline manager will ask you two questions, which is what do you want? Why do you want to work for Emirates? And why do you want to be a flight attendant? So you have to know these two answers very clearly, confidently, and you have to have impressed the airline manager. So you can go for the further process. If in this interview you will not impress the airline manager, you will get rejection letter. If you will get selected, you will go for the next stage, that is the English test. It is in this test, there will be a two-story given to you, and there will be a 5 question. So you have to, here they will check your verbal comprehension abilities and how you are writing, presenting your answer. They will judge your personality, the question in such a way, they will judge your personality. So you have to give all the details, all answer in such a way that it will look a very organized, a very technical, and it shows your personality. The next stage is the essay writing test. After clearing that test, you have to go through the essay writing test. So in this test, they will give us one topic. So you have to write an essay for that. It can be anything, like you recently you have visited any country or any places. You have to write a thank you letter, or they can ask you to write a report writing about a holiday or anything. So you have to write an essay. They will check your writing abilities here. The next, again, you have to go through the group discussion. This is the second group discussion. In this, people will be splitted into 20 members in one team. And they will provide you a question. Question can be like this. There has been a mixed up at the airport. Even though 20 people had places order for hire cars, there are only 10 cars available. What should you do? So there, the question will be like this. And you, at the end of the discussion, what happens? One of the assessor comes and plays the part that someone who didn't receive the car. So you have to convince that person. And you have to provide a solution to that person. Here, they will check you, check your leadership qualities and how quick decision you are taking and how you are managing the passenger when he is not getting a car according to this question, he is not getting a car. So how you are managing and how you are communicating, everything they will check here. The next test will be the personality test. So after the third elimination, this test will go. So in this test, you have to go through a psychometric test. So in this, they will check your personality profiling test. In this test, you have 45 minutes and there will be a 180 questions. So you have to answer all the questions. Here they will check your personality, what you are thinking, how you are taking the situation, how you are managing. Questions will be like this, how you are managing. A situation question will be also there. Now comes to the benefits. So once you join the airline, so what all the accommodation and transport benefit you get from the Emirates airline once you join. So when you reach to the Dubai, before arriving to Dubai, you will get all the accommodation and apartment and there are so many apartments in the Dubai. So after completing all the tests, if you get the invitation letter, so you have after joining, you have to go to the Dubai. So the accommodation will be fully furnished, but you have to pay your TV bill and phone bill and internet services. And Emirates Airline will provide a free shuttle bus between your accommodation and the airport. And if you are married, so you can stay outside also, but you have to pay your own allowances. What all the other benefits for the Emirates flight attendant is, your uniform will be fully paid by the company and dry cleaning and laundry service will be provided. And you can purchase unlimited number of tickets on the discount of 90%. And you will also get a limited 2 tickets per person Tatkal every year. And you will stay in a 4 or 5 star hotel. And the flight attendant of Club of Emirates offer a special discount in Dubai and the Bay Area. You can get money to beach clubs, restaurants, gyms and retail outlets. What all the services of after leaving the company, what all the services you will get? So instead of pension, what you will receive is it is a paid as a lump sum when you leave the company. For the first 5 years, this is equivalent to 21 days final basic salary, and this amount will increase for service for 5 years. And cabin crew or overnight allowance. So to pay the food and the drink paid in a local currency when the crew arrived at hotel, the amount is paid is dependent on the length of the stay, and you have to pay the tax according to your country. In your country, you have to check for that. It is depend on your nationality from where you are. And there will be a contract agreement for Emirates Airlines crew member. So the new crew, cabin crew is required to sign a 3-year contract, that is 36 months. So for the first 6 months, you will be a probationary period. So here you have to stay in the cabin crew accommodation area. And during the first 12 months, Emirates will charge 334 AED from your salary for every month if you do not fulfill the 3-year contract. If you will leave the company, so you have to pay the charge. And if you will complete the contract, so after completion, what bonus you will get is around 6,000 AED you will get. What all the benefits for the cabin crew Emirates Airline? So the starting salary will be around 4,260 per month, and the flying pay will be the 61.25 per hour, and total average will be around now 9,760 per month. Talking about the labor expenses, so meal allowance are provided in the currency of the country of night stop, hotel accommodation as well as transport to and from the airport is provided by the company, and concessional travel. So staff will be benefit on the Emirates Airline can be availed as per the staff travel manual. These all the benefits again once you join what all the accommodation benefits you will get. So transport in this meal allowance are provided in the currency of the country where you are staying. So in that currency meal allowance are provided, and hotel accommodation as well as transport will be the provided by the company if you go to the other country or other places. So all the accommodation will be provided by the airline only. Now come to the cabin crew interview question and answers. So the first question is, tell me about yourself. So you have to give the answer in such a way that you are presenting yourself and how much dedicated you are toward your work, and how what you have done in the past, and what why you want to join, and all the things you have to tell about yourself, all the details from where you are. So for this, I have written this answer. I have been working for a company, Pace Group International, for the last 2 months. I started out as a part-time sales representative. Meanwhile, I graduated from college, Karunya Institute of Technology and Sciences, with a major in BTech Aerospace Engineering. Now the second question is, what are your strengths? So my strength is, I am a team player with excellent attention to detail. I also have the ability to adapt to a fast-paced environment. And they can ask you about your weakness also, and they will ask you, tell me about your dream job. So what is your dream job? You have to tell them what your dream job, why, what you wanted to do in your life. So my dream, the answer is, my dream job will give me the opportunity to travel and discover new culture and interesting people. This is the work that makes me excited to wake up every day, go to work, and constantly learn something new. You can write your own answer. What is your dream job? You can write. You have to write your own answer. The next question is, why do you want to work for our airline? So why do you want to work? So you have to write an answer that should impress the manager. And it should be a real, natural answer. It should not be a copy paste or any from someone. You have to give your answer and a very impressive answer. So I know that your company has been one of the fastest growing airline in the world, winning many awards and openness to cultural diversity. I would be honored to be the part of such an ambitious team. So they can ask you, do you work better in a team or alone? So you have, you should never say you like to work alone. This is my point of view, because teamwork is better than alone. So answer can be like, I like to work in group, but I enjoy being part of the work that is my personal responsibility. Yes, if it is your work, you have it is your personal work, so that you have to do alone. But in a company, you have to be you have to work in a team. The next is, how would your friends and co-workers describe you? So how your friends, and if you have worked in the past, how they describe you, you have to say that answer. The next is, have you ever worked with someone you didn't like? If so, how did you handle it? So you have to give, you should never say that I didn't like that person, I don't want to work with that person. If any situation come like this, so you have to resolve that situation, and you have to make again a very good communication and a bond with that person. You should have never said that I didn't work with someone I didn't like. What do you expect from supervisor? So you have to give an answer of like, you should have an answer for this, a very good answer. I hope to guide and support them. I also appreciate a supervisor who is very fair, honest, and encourage the professional development of each person on the team. And he or she should be a very grateful. My manager also praised my efforts. The manager should praise your efforts. The next question is, why should I hire you? This is the question which mostly all the manager will ask, why should I hire you? So you have answer with a technical, your leadership, everything, include your answer, and it should be a very organized answer. So you should hire me because I have expertise and experience in the field of customer service. I aim for excellence in everything I do and will give my full energy and get excellent service for my clients. I have exceeded all my goals and expectations of my client in my previous work by offering personal care, attention to detail, and energy in my work. The next question can be, how will you able to cope with working such long shift? So if some situation comes where you have to work for a long time, so it is your duty, if you are working in any company and they require for, if any emergency situation, they require you for a long time. So you have to work for them because it's your responsibility. And it shows your leadership qualities also. So you have to give that answer to, what is the kind of person you refuse to work with? So for this also, you should not say like, I don't want to work this kind of person or this thing. Instead of that, you can say, I can work with all kind of people. If any is, if something happen or something comes, you have answer with the situation and answer that I can make a bond and I can make them resolve the, I can resolve the issues, and try to make all the answer very positive. The next question can be, what motivates you to do the best on the job? So this is the very good question, and you have to answer, you have to give answers like, I always felt that it is important for me personally and for the company to provide excellent service and to have extremely happy customer day. The next question can be, how long do you expect to work for us if hired? So for this, if you have worked for the if you have worked previously, you can take an example for that, how long you have worked. So if you have not worked, then you have to give an answer that you are a loyal person, you can work with them. You have to make them understand that you will stay in your company, you are a honest person, and you are a dedicated person to your work, your responsibility. What did you do to prepare for this interview? So for the cabin crew Emirates interview, if they ask you what did you do, you can say that I am reading aviation news online, and I have subscribed to your airline newspaper, and I have done some research on life in Dubai, and you can say like what did you do, what all the things you have done for this interview, you can say that. The next can be, are you applying for any other airline? What if more than one airline offer you the job? So for this, you have to say is, I will consider all the factors in my decision making and I will choose the employer which is the best for my career aspiration. Your airline seems like a place for me. So you have to convince that if any other airline will offer you, so for which airline you will go. So you have to make them understand that which will be best for you, you will go for that. And you will also say that your airline seems like a place for me, or this platform is good for me, anything. You can make them understand that you wanted to work with them. They can ask you some they can ask you some question, like basic general knowledge question. So you have to you should know which any airline if you are going to join, so you should know all the things about that airline. So they can ask like how many flight attendants are there in the world. So how many are there, it depends on the year, so you can say according to that. The next is, how old do you have to be a flight attendant? If you have joined, how old do you have to be a flight attendant? So it depends on the airline. For Emirates Airline, you must be 18 years of age to become the flight. For Emirates Airline, you must be a 21 year old, and for other, maybe you can join at the age of 18 also. So next is, what do you wear to for the flight attendant interview? So it should be a formal dress code with a formal shoes. It should be it should like a business casual dress. They can ask you a question, how would you resolve a dispute between two passengers? So as a cabin crew, so if dispute happened between two passengers, how you are going to manage with them? So you can say like this, dispute between who gets a certain seat is something I have witnessed on more than one occasion. If you have worked before, or if you have traveled, maybe you have seen something happen like this. So the last time this happened, a couple had purchased seat apart from one other but wanted to sit together. The person in the seat next to the woman did not want to leave, so it caused a bit of an argument. I had to serve a moderator. I walked over to where the man had his seat and asked the passenger next to him if she would be willing to move. That man agreed without any hassle, so everyone was able to sit where they wanted. So you have to give an answer to resolve the dispute between the two passengers, and you have to give you can give a different situation, different answer. Do you work better by yourself, in yourself, or in a group? Again, it came this question came. So you have to give the answer whether you can work you do work better by yourself or in a group. So you have to provide answer according to you. And at the last, the airline manager will ask you, do you have any question for me? So you can ask question like this, I would like to know what does the airline value the most. Then you can ask the question, what is the most important thing that I should do to contribute in my first month of flying? And you can ask, when your top performing crew leave the airline and why do they leave? And fourth one is, how do you think I perform during the assessment? You can ask this question to the airline manager. Thank you.